Okay, so this is going to be about the project I've been working on, which is my very own homemade RC transmitter, which can be used for quadcopter and RC helicopters and stuff. As you can see, I have the most basic one, which is a flash LCD6P, two analog joystick on this side and two analog joystick on this side, which makes us 4-channel, and 2-channel for the switches. So what I made is this, which uses an RF2400 1 plus module, which comes with the power amplifier and an antenna attachment, external antenna attachment, as you can see, and I interface it with the Arduino Mega and two analog joystick to act as an alternative to this FlashCast CD6P, and in future I'm going to interface this Nokia 510 LCD module to it, so I could see the data which is being transmitted or the data received with the acknowledgement from the receiving end, which would basically contain the GPS data or the attribute data. So yeah, let me show you around how this thing works. Yeah, so this is the program for the Arduino Mega, which is the transmitting end of the side system, and as you can see, yeah, the data being transmitted right now is around 125. So if I bring it to the lowest position, it would go to the zero, and if I bring it to the top position, it would be around 255. So the data is between, the data is around is 1 byte actually. I divided by 4 so that it is 8 bits, 1 byte. As you can see, joysticks are working quite well. And this joystick data is being transmitted to the receiving end, which is our Arduino Nano, which is basically Nutmega 328 microcontroller, which is smaller in size. Which is basically an Arduino Uno, which is just smaller in size. And what I use on the receiving end is this RF2401 with the PCB antenna. I could actually use the power amplifier module on the receiving end too, but the problem with the Nano was the supply wasn't really sufficient. The 3.3 volt supply wasn't sufficient to supply the enough current to make the module work. So yeah, the data being transmitted right now is this, as you can see, and this would be the receiving side data. Yeah, let's see, take a look at that. So as you can see, the frequency is around 25 hertz. So the PWM data is being updated 25 times per second. And you can see the PWM data is currently 1500, which means all the joysticks are at the middle position. If I bring them down at the zero position, you can see it changed to 1000. At the topmost position, it changed to 2000. So you can see if I move it around a little bit. So yeah, it carries very well. So I think it's kind of fine. So let me show you the feature which I enabled in it, which is auto retransmit and acknowledgement. Once the data is being acknowledged, well, let me show you. If I remove the receiving end of the system, as you can see, I remove the receiver, we can see the maximum retransmit. The data is being retransmitted and the interrupt is being caught. So now, if I reattach it, you can see it's sure gonna. Just wait a second. Since I reattached it, it's gonna start again. Let's do this one more time and detach the receiver. You can see it's again retransmitting the data, but data is not able to reach the receiver. And once again I attach the receiver, it's gonna start again automatically. It takes a little time to kick in because the setup, I'm gonna take care of the timing later on. So you can see the receiver is receiving the data again. Yeah, So that's all I wanted to show.